Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm on your Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World project using Python language on our PyCharm IDE. And I'm also going to show you how you can easily run that on our PyCharm. Alright, so do watch the video till the end. If you like the video, please give it a like and also do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. And if you face any issues in middle, please do put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So to install PyCharm, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in that dashboard, you need to simply search with PyCharm download and hit enter. And this will show you this download PyCharm Python IDE for professional. So you need to just simply click on this link, and it's going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So this link I am going to put in our description, so you can directly using that link you can navigate to this site. Alright, so this is a PyCharm professional one, and if you scroll down here you'll get PyCharm community edition. So you need to click on this download button in order to download it for Windows. So you can see it has rightly started downloading PyCharm. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory. And here you can see that our latest version of PyCharm, which is version 2023.2, is already been downloaded over here. And the file size is 415 MB. Alright. So now to install PyCharm, we need to just simply double click on the installer. And it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And it's going to show you this welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup window. So let's minimize our download directory, and here you can just simply click on next. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. So program files is JetBrains, and within that they're going to create this PyCharm Community Edition version 2023.2 folder. Alright, so everything is fine. You can just simply click on next. And here under installation options, they have given some checkboxes. So the first one is whether you'd like to create a desktop shortcut. So as in my previous video, I have shown you how to install IntelliJ IDEA. So that time also you can see that desktop shortcut is created over here. Similarly, when you select this, it's going to create a PyCharm desktop shortcut right after that. All right. And I'll be also recommending you to select this open folder as project. So what happens is, if you have any project which is written in Python, let's say, so you can just simply right click on that folder, and it's going to show you this option, open folder as project. So with this you can easily open any folder right at your PyCharm IDE, which is very easy to navigate. All right. So do select that option, and this is for Python, so .py extension. So select this, and also you need to select this add bin folder to path. So what happens is, it automatically set our bin folder path location in our environment variable, which is a very good thing. So do select that. You need to restart your system. I'm going to tell you at what point you need to restart your system. So for the time being, select everything and click on next. And it's going to create this JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation has rightly began. Also, our desktop shortcut is also rightly created over here. All right. So this installing PyCharm will take a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to again coming back to this video. Yeah. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our PyCharm is rightly installed, and it is giving you a couple of options whether you'd like to reboot your system now or you'd like to manually reboot later. I'll be recommending you to select this reboot now option and click on finish. So what it will do is, it will going to restart your system, and after that we can again, you know, start our video. So let's reboot your system. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to the desktop, and here you can see we have PyCharm Community Edition rightly created. So just simply double click on the PyCharm shortcut in order to launch our PyCharm, and you can see our PyCharm is rightly started launching. So before that, it will ask you whether you'd like to import your old Python settings. So if you are installing it for the first time, you can just simply, you know, select this do not import settings and click on OK. And you'll be seeing our PyCharm is rightly started launching, and it will also ask you to give firewall permission. So you can just simply click on this allow access to give permission and all. So our PyCharm is rightly open. Welcome to PyCharm. You can maximize this. So this is the interface of our PyCharm. I'll be now showing you how you can easily create a simple PyCharm project. So click on this new project and it's going to open this new project window. So here you need to give your project name. So I'm going to give project name as Hello World. And here you can see on this location, it's going to create our Hello World project. And the base interpreter is Python 3.9. So currently I don't have Python on my system. So it's going to, you know, install our Python from here. You can choose any of this version, Python 3.9 or 3.10. I'm going to choose the latest version, Python 3.10. All right. And all other things are fine. It's going to create main.py welcome script as well. So you can keep all other things as default and click on create. And what it will do is it's going to start creating our project. So before that, it will see that it don't have Python. So it needs to download our Python. So it's going to start downloading our Python. So you can see downloading our Python. So this will entire process will take time. You need to have active internet connection as well, because it is fetching the files and going to install it on our system. So, you know, I have some patience, and after that I'm going to again come back to this video. So after installing Python, it will show you this creating the virtual environment. So you can see that our Hello World project is now created. So this is our Hello World project, and this is our, you know, main.py file. So here they have already given a default code. So this is our main method. So here we are calling this printtime method by passing this parameter PyCharm, and here we are printing this PyCharm, right? So if you just simply click on this run button, you can see the output Hi PyCharm is rightly shown on our console. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PyCharm on your Windows operating system. If you want to edit anything on this code, you can just simply remove all, and you can, you know, start working over here, right? So, you know, that's basically all about this video. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in your comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.